Good morning, I am Dr. Vijay Prakash and today I will be telling you about Kennedy's classification and Applegate's modification. Now, Kennedy's classification is one of the most widely used classification and it was originally proposed by Dr. Edward Kennedy in 1925. The original classification consists of four classes and it mostly applies to most of the situation in a partially edentulous cases. Why it has been widely used? Because it is simple, it is logical, and it is universal, it is widely accepted. However, there is one problem with this classification, that it cannot quantify the amount of support for the tooth borne or distal extension cases. Now, edentulous areas other than the classification are referred to as modification spaces. Coming on to these classifications, first is class 1. Class 1 is a bilateral, you can see bilateral edentulous space or areas which are located posterior to remaining anterior natural teeth. So this is class 1 where you have, bilaterally you have a missing spaces. And similarly you have a class 2 in which you have a unilateral edentulous area located posterior to the remaining natural teeth, as you can see. These are remaining natural teeth and you have a posterior edentulous space, but this is only unilateral. Again, class 3 is a unilateral edentulous space which is bounded by natural teeth both anterior and posterior to it. So you have a edentulous space which is having natural teeth both anterior and posterior to it. Then you have a class 4. Class 4 is a single bilateral anterior edentulous space which crosses the midline. Suppose it is not crossing the midline, then it will be class 3. But if it crosses, that means both the central incisors are missing and it crosses the midline, then it is referred to as class 4. Now, O.C. Applegate, Dr. O.C. Applegate modified Kennedy's classification and he gave two more additional classification. One was class 5, in which you have an edentulous area which is bounded by natural teeth both anterior and posterior to it, but the anterior abutment is not that suitable for support. Suppose, for example, say canine is missing, then you have a premolar and a lateral incisor. As we all know, that lateral incisor is not having a good support. So if you have this kind of situation, then it is referred to as a class 5. It is referred to as a class 5. Now, class 6 is a teeth adjacent to the edentulous space which is capable of providing complete support to the processes. Say for example, if premolar is missing and you have a canine and the second premolar, so both these abutment are strong enough to provide support to replace a missing first premolar. So this will be referred to as a class 6 classification, that is Applegate modification of Kennedy's classification. Now, Applegate also referred to different rules of applying Kennedy's classification. Rule number 1 is classification should follow rather than precede the extraction of the teeth. That is, if you are planning for extraction of the tooth, then first you extract the teeth and then only you classify that particular case. Rule number 2 is, if the third molar is missing and it is not to be replaced, then it is not considered in the classification. Third rule is, if third molar is present and you want to use it as an abutment, then it is considered in the classification. Rule number 4 is, if a second molar is missing and we are not replacing it, suppose the opposing tooth is not present, opposing second molar is not present, then we do not consider the second molar into the classification. Rule number 5 is very important. The most posterior edentulous area will determine the classification. Always, in all these classifications which we see, it is the most posterior area which is determining the classification. Next rule is rule number 6. Edentulous areas other than those determining the classification are referred to as modification space. So for example, you have a class 2 situation like this, and suppose this molar is missing. So this is one edentulous space other than the classification. The posteriormost part is determining the classification, that is class 2. Now if this molar is missing, then this becomes class 2 modification 1. Similarly, if another tooth is missing, say a canine is missing or a lateral is missing, then you will have two edentulous spaces. So this will become class 2 modification 2, and so on and so forth. If you have more number of edentulous spaces, they will be added as modification spaces. Rule number 7 is extent of the modification is not considered. Now extent of the modification means, suppose one molar is missing or two adjacent teeth are missing. This extent is not considered in the classification. It's only the edentulous spaces, how many edentulous spaces we are having, which will determine the modification number. Rule number 8, that is the last rule, is class 4 does not have any modification, because any modification, any tooth which is missing posterior to this will be class 3 and not class 4. Then it will be class 3 modification 1. So that is the reason why class 4 does not have any modification. This brings to end of Kennedy's classification. Thank you for watching the video.